Hello and welcome to the C-Suite at the Open Video Series with TMX. My name is Omar Kafegi, a client success specialist based in Toronto. And joining me today is Brad Loisel, the CEO of Better You Education Corp. Hello and welcome, Brad.
Thank you, Omar. It's great to be here with you guys. Thank you for taking the time.
So Brad, can you tell us a little bit more about Better You?
Sure. We started in 2013 with a vision to help solve access to education to individuals across mass markets. We focused on India originally, and we're still doing business over there. It's taken years to build up this platform, which is an education technology platform that has brought together educators from all over the world. We have about 100 corporate partners, institutional partners, about 50,000 programs from kindergarten all the way up to skills development programs on our marketplace in India. And we're basically an education company that is trying to solve the different variables across education, from kindergarten all the way up to skills development, corporate training problems. We just launched a B2B program this year called Ready to Go. We're unique in the sense that no one has been able to bring together the quantity and scope across all levels of education anywhere in the world. We're the first to do it. It's taken a long time and a lot of investment and effort, but we're at that tipping point right now, which is great.
And how was your business impacted by COVID-19, and how did you adapt to the changes?
It's interesting. I've been an entrepreneur for a long time, built other companies, and I knew that when this issue happened with COVID, I knew it was going to have an impact on the corporates and the business partners that we were dealing with. In 2008, when the financial industry went through the same challenges in the market, we knew that companies, employers were not going to be focused on hiring and partnering with new companies and trying to bring on skills development programs, especially with the flood of people having to go work from home. I knew right away that all the sales efforts that we had just started, and we landed two pretty good customers. One was a large customer in the US, but I knew right away it was going to have an impact. So we stopped focusing on sales and we focused on how can we use the technology that we had built for corporates to transform it to support the challenges that they were facing. So we put together a COVID-19 full resource toolkit that included everything you can think about when it came to this virus, and support for families at home, working from home, support for kids that were trying to understand what was going on with school. So we built this toolkit and then we started marketing it for free. We talked to all of our partners and asked them if they can contribute to this so that we can help support companies in need, so that can help them fast track and get through the current issues that they're dealing with. Our current customers jumped on board, loved it, provided it to all their employees. We got great responses, and it just validates the technology that we've been putting together that it works. We've been launching it across all over the world. Different groups in India and the US and Canada have been adopting it and using it. And we use that as a way to help others and then get through that. And now we're at a stage where so many more people have adopted it, which is really great and opens the door for our corporate opportunities too.
And Brad, other than your shift of focus from growing your sales to providing more support to your current partners, what are some of the other growth plans that you have for the company?
Well, with Ready to Go, our strategy, these are all lessons learned that we've taken away from our experience in India. It's very complex. The education industry across all B2B corporates are very, there's a lot of constraints that prevent HR resources from developing proper skills programs across their entire organization. It requires a lot of content from a lot of different partners, the integration of multiple technologies because they are dealing with multiple partners. So our thought was leveraging everything we've built over the years, the thousands of programs that we have, integrated into one mobile device that enables skill gap analysis, integration of different content from different providers, really simplifying the entire process for these corporates. We launched it this year and we landed Paramount Staffing as a customer from the US, one of the largest staffing companies in the US. Most people don't know this and we haven't talked about it, but they're owned by ProMan. ProMan has over 50,000 employees, 20,000 plus global clients. And we've been talking about possible strategic partnerships and how to grow into those organizations. Our growth plans are including these big companies that are trying to solve this problem that need access to a lot of different content from a lot of different providers. They can get it all through us in one simple app, easy access, skill gap analysis, one price per month. It's a SaaS model. So we have the ability to really scale this out, and it's available in every language you can think of. So once programs get entering the system, it automatically gets translated into multiple languages. So it makes it for a great scalable product. So our growth over this next year is going to be quite good. We have a great partner now, and we have more customers that we're working on. But no one has built technology and integration like we have. It's taken years. It's nothing that just happened recently. It's all coming together, though.
Great. And finally, when talking to investors, how do you describe BetterU as an attractive investment proposition firm?
Well, you know, what's interesting is right now is the time where everyone's going online. We've been working in the online space since 2008. I built and sold a company in 2011 in the edtech space and built this knowing where the market was going to go eventually for the emerging markets. We have great foothold in India. We have great partnerships. The ambassador of India just joined our board of advisors. You know, he's helping us with Indian growth and opportunities there. We have created something that no one else has done. And I'll just give a quick example. If you look at Expedia and how Expedia works, you go in, type your destination, where you want to go, time, all that kind of stuff. They have a simple process, but a very complex backend. People all over the world can go into the system, find the destination they want, and then they get served up with what they need. We've been doing the same for education, integrating everybody together, one simple app that makes it simple for HR groups to expand their scope of education to all their employees across anything, really. So we're, from an investment perspective, we're a very unique company that has been doing this for a very long time. And we're at the tipping point right now, and we've developed and fine-tuned the product. And the results are the customers we just landed. More coming, for sure. So it's a great opportunity to invest in us, especially with where the market is today.
Well, that's great, Brad. Well, thank you very much for joining us today. And I hope that you stay safe and that you stay well.
I appreciate it. Thank you for having me.